We know that this obesity epidemic is taking its toll. We know that if we keep this up, this will be the first generation to not outlive their parents. Here we have this epidemic of obese six-month-olds. And everyone's saying, how is it possible? How can that be? They don't diet and exercise. They just get fed formula or breast milk and they're obese. How is that possible? Well, it's very possible. Number one, you lay down your fat before you're born. And what determines how much fat you lay down? The baby's insulin before they're born. The more insulin, the more fat. And what determines that baby's insulin? The mother's diet.
We need to focus on prevention. When does prevention start? In little kids? In kindergarten? No, it's even earlier. Is it about breastfeeding versus giving them the bottle? That's even too late to start there. It starts in the womb. And it starts actually even before conception in the woman's health. And so young women are shaping the future generation's health. They're the gatekeepers. And so we should be putting a lot more effort into promoting a healthy generation of women because they are absolutely shaping the next generation and whether they're coming out all set up for obesity.
We know that birth weights have been going up over the last 25 years worldwide. And we know that mother's weight gain during pregnancy, which has also been going up, translates into baby's adiposity, baby's fat stores. So fat cells like to get filled. As soon as they're out, they're hungry. And we see these kids calling for food at age 2 months, 3 months, and the parents don't know where this came from. And it's because they were programmed to do so.
So what happens to a child who had an obese mom? They might have come out of the womb small for their age or low birth weight, but very soon after that, we see how their metabolic calibration is set in this world. It's set so that they are absolutely efficient and thrifty with calories. So they may have catch-up growth. They may have a period of rapid growth where all of a sudden they've gone from being small to being plump. And then they're actually at risk for childhood obesity.
We used to say if a child was overweight or obese, that didn't necessarily predict that they were going to be an adult that's obese. And now it's starting to track across time.
If you have childhood obesity, you're likely to become an obese adult. And if you've had obesity for that long of a duration, you're likely to have early onset of that whole range of obesity-related diseases. So it's a trajectory that starts with these young women. And if we can't help women who are obese and high stress, if we cannot help them, then we are absolutely determining the future of their offspring.
When a woman enters pregnancy at a higher weight, either overweight or obese, she's more likely to gain either inadequate weight or excessive weight per the Institute of Medicine guidelines. So if women are gaining excessive weight and they're already at high weights, this is bad for the woman. She's more likely to have a cesarean section. She's more likely to have gestational diabetes, for example. And it puts the fetus at risk because the fetus then can suffer growth retardation or be born with at a large birth weight.
So pregnancy is another period that I think as a society we need to rally around and bolster up women's both mental and physical health because that is a short little window where we can dramatically influence the outcomes. The other change that I would suggest is that we think about obesity prevention starting with women of childbearing age. Women who are not even pregnant yet because they are shaping health of our future generations.
As a girl matures, we know that obesity is influencing younger ages of puberty, and the need to develop and mature and go through her own reproduction will influence hanging on to calories and hanging on to fat.
If they are obese, they are already programming the new little ones that are coming to the world to be set up for obesity and early disease.
We know that people are dying younger. We've actually seen it now in the data. This last year, 2009 to 2010, we saw a decline in mean lifespan of 3 months. The first time in the history of the world where lifespan started to go down instead of up. So this is the gift that keeps on giving. And this can actually be transmitted from generation to generation. Fixing the diet is not just a question of fixing the diet for children, but fixing the diet for the mother who's pregnant, which means fixing the diet for the mother before she comes pregnant, which means all the way back. In other words, fixing it for everybody. That is a public health intervention.